Making PowerPoint Active Not Passive is a training session by Dave Foord as part of the A6 Training and Consultancy Limited company. Now, PowerPoint gets a very bad press, unfortunately, because a lot of people do use it badly and create very ineffective, passive presentations, which are not necessarily good for learning. The idea of this training session is to work out how we can use PowerPoint so that the learning is active rather than passive. If we get the students doing things rather than just watching the screen, it can make the learning a much more powerful and effective medium. This training session, we just use basic PowerPoint skills, and it will just have a simple set of ideas and things that can be done. And by putting them together in different ways, we can create very engaging presentations. One of the things that will be covered is the idea of editable text boxes. This is very, very quick and easy to set up. You just choose however many boxes you want on the screen, where you want them, what colour. And then in the session, you can get the students' input to fill out the boxes. So here I've got simple advantages and disadvantages. We can have a discussion with the students, and they can then type, or you can type into the box. At the end of the session, you can save your lists for future reference. Very simple, very, very effective. Another idea is using countdown timers. If you're setting the students any sort of task, whether it's on the computers or on the desks, if we set a timer to keep them to time limit, it will help sessions be a lot more punchy and flow and stick to schedule. Here's an example of a 10-second timer. It will count down from 10 to 0. There are different time increments and there are different styles of timers dependent on the situation. And these are very easy to just copy and paste into your existing or new presentations. Another thing that we'll look at is some basic drawing skills. So if you're drawing things like a diagram, in this case it's like a flowchart, it's having all the shapes the same size, the same shape, having them equally aligned, having the arrows arranged so that in the middle of the shapes and they don't overlap or drop short of the target. If you have things that look neat, look professional, it's more likely that the learning will also be more professional and higher quality. If we have diagrams that are a bit messy, not quite right, students will be focusing on that rather than the actual learning that's being taken place. Having created a diagram like this, we've then got various options. One of the things that we can do is we can use hyperlinking. So here I've set it up so that if I click on any of the boxes within my diagram, it will jump to a page for that box. Now I could have additional information over on the right hand side explaining that part. Or I can just use it as a labelling sort of idea. It looks very professional, looks quite smart. Here I'm doing it with a flowchart, but you can just as easily do it with a photograph, where you click on different parts of the photograph and it will take you to a page labelling whatever it is that they've clicked on, maybe giving additional information. And that's all done within PowerPoint. Nothing fancy, just some simple, straightforward skills within PowerPoint. Another thing that we can do with our flowchart is we can have some basic animations. Now, some animations in PowerPoint are just fancy and annoying is probably the best way of describing them. But simple animations like we've got here, where we build up the diagram piece by piece as we're explaining it, can actually help the learning significantly. Rather than us just giving them the whole picture at the start and then talking about it, we can build it up piece by piece and help the learners to understand as they go through. And other things that we'll cover in the session are ways in which we can get the learners to create their own presentations rather than us as tutors having to do it all up front. All the details on training sessions can be found on the website, which is www.a6training.co.uk, and my contact details are on there, so if you want to contact to discuss prices or particular activities in the session, then please do that. I've been Dave Foord, and this is how making PowerPoint active, not passive.